I'm Neha, Executive Member of Media and Public Relations Committee. It gives me immense pleasure to introduce all of you to our guest,
Mr. Vasmant.
He's the Director and Global Head of Sutherland Global Services. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, I would like to ask you that in this dynamic world of technology, here students are technically efficient, very much proficient in technology. So what do you think, how can present scenario be steered so that progress can be enhanced?
Okay, let me try and understand your question first. So you're basically saying students are good at technology.
Yes, sir.
But you want to get insights on what you can do to make sure
that the future is better. Yes, sir, to increase the progress.
Okay, so here's my two cents on this. So when you say you're good at technology, what part of technology are you good at? Are you good at software? Are you good at analyzing data, etc., etc.? So normally you'll find that you're management students. So management cannot exist in a vacuum, right? So management has to be in a context. So any technology or any management that you do has to come along with deep business experience in a particular sector, right? So for example, just technology experience or management experience, without an experience in, let's say, textiles, fashion, in oil, natural gas, or whatever, the moment you are able to get deep experience in a particular sector, tie it up with technology, along with the management expertise, then I think you're pretty set. Right? So I think that's going to be the critical linkage as far as future proofing is concerned, focusing on specific areas of expertise.
Another thing, sir, what do you think is the penetration percentage of robotic process automation in Sutherland? As you know, Sutherland is offering many opportunities, many exploring opportunities for the emerging market. So what do you think related to robotic process automation, what can be done?
So, Sutherland does robotic process automation in multiple areas. Okay? So I'll give you one example. One example is there are very transactional areas, right, where you have a call coming in and somebody is responding to the call. So that can easily be replaced by a voice on automation system. Then you have systems, for example, where you have a call coming in, people need to decide based upon certain inputs of the call where it needs to be routed. So that routing is another very critical part where we can actually figure out that the business is able to make the decision. The software is able to make the decision without actually involving the person. So that's the second thing. The third part is there are various automations that we drive for our clients worldwide, which helps them improve their customer experience as well. In terms of the actual penetration percentage, I don't have a figure for you, but in terms of what we are doing, what we've done recently is we've consolidated the entire operations of various units in what is called as digital services. And there's going to be a focus on automation of robotics, not only for us but for our clients as well.
Sir, what key mantras would you like to give to a budding managers of IIM Raipur?
The first is keep going as you have, because it's been an impressive show by you organizing this. You've got a phenomenal brand behind you. So utilize the brand and try to understand the future. Do not go with the flow of what it is today. Try to understand about the world that you're going to be in the future and try to focus your attention on that, because the world's changing so fast and you need to keep yourself relevant. So that would be my.
And how was your overall experience at IIM Raipur?
I think you guys have done a fantastic job. Like I said during the function, and I've said multiple times, I think you've done better than I've seen organizing in many companies. So keep up the good work. Thanks to all of you for hosting us, and